Well, India has an estimated 26,000 startups, making it the third largest startup ecosystem in the world, recording consolidated inflows of over $36 billion in the past 3 years, with 26 unicorn startups valued at over $1 billion. The Indian startup ecosystem has expanded quite rapidly, mainly through private investments, including seed, angel, venture capital and private equity funds, with technical support from incubators, accelerators and the government. Resha Mandi, India's first silk tech startup that serves a B2B marketplace for silk farmers, businesses and retailers in India, has recently announced a Series A funding round of $30 million. Led by a global alternative investment manager, Creation Investments Capital Management, LLC and other investors. Founded in May 2020, Resha Mandi provides a full-stack digital ecosystem starting from farm to fashion. The company was founded by Mayank Tiwari, a NIFT gold medalist, Saurabh Agarwal, former Cisco Systems technologist and entrepreneur, and Utkarsh Apurva, a serial technology entrepreneur from IIT Delhi. Resha Mandi is currently one of the fastest growing B2B startups in India, which is witnessing an increase of 30x in revenue in the first year of operation. Let us get an insider perspective from Mr. Mayank Tiwari himself on how Resha Mandi is propelling the vision of Atmanirbhar Bharat and making India Atmanirbhar in silk production. My first question to you, Mayank, is what made you conceptualize the Resha Mandi app and what is its USP?
Resha Mandi got conceptualized during my college days, primarily around 2004 timeframe, when I went for a cluster development program in nearby Indore. And I realized that the rural produce that was, you know, very cheaply available at that point in time there in Bagh and Maheshwar and Chanderi, but I wasn't able to find the same produce in Mumbai. And if I'm able to find it, it's 10x cost. And I kind of saw a lot of gap there in terms of how the supply is coming down to the consumer. I did my graduation project also in the same lines of doing an Indian handicraft craftsman to consumer kind of a story. And that problem statement kind of continued to exist. And even today, the problem statement continues. So when I actually started off thinking something of my own, I thought that, you know, I'll probably start in, you know, natural fiber space, handloom or handicraft sector, but natural fiber kind of encompasses all the three sectors. So it helped me propel that vision. And idea was to not create a platform, but to create an ecosystem where the stakeholders are able to get the benefit of the right pricing, the right quality, with the trust, transparency, and also to do with the fact that, you know, there is somebody that, you know, who's assuring them right time to market, right time to inputs, advising them as to how they need to do the production, and making sure that they're you know, they're excelling not only on in terms of, you know, their production capabilities, but also excelling in terms of their revenues going.
Mayank, also tell us, why is the Series A funding pivotal to the startup, tech and sericulture and also natural fiber sector in India?
So our Series A funding is not only pivotal to only the silk space or the sericulture space. I think it's pivotal to the B2B space in India, because this is the largest Series A round in the B2B setup or B2B e-commerce companies across India. And you can pick up any of the names who are now the unicorns. This Series A is phenomenal from that standpoint. And also to do with the fact that it kind of now helps us propel this knowledge that we have gathered in and around Karnataka. We've been primarily around Karnataka, right, from the farmers' standpoint. But now we can expand towards Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, move towards Jammu Kashmir, move towards Northeast.
How then is the Resha Mandi app a proponent of the Atmanirbhar Bharat mission?
Okay, so from the Atmanirbhar Bharat perspective, now we are trying to make sure that not only we are cultivating a practice where silk, the indigenous silk that India produces, is is of better quality, and we are also making sure that they are competing against China in its quality.
Mayank, thank you for joining us on Republic TV and sharing your valuable insights. We wish you the absolute best in your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thanks for the call.
and up ahead.